Me, so Ivo, what does that mean anyway? What's the now?
Ivo, it has to do with living in the moment, my love.
Me, so what does that mean?
Ivo, living in the moment is the only thing possible. Your people live in the past or the future, and these are non-realities. They are memories, held by the mind. The only lifetime to live is this present moment.
Me, so what if I want to relive an old memory?
Ivo, this is not so bad, but many stay stuck in their old memories and do not move on. They do not embrace their current reality because they are reliving their memories. In the same way, they live in anticipation of the future, which is not here yet. By doing this, they lose the ability to be happy, now.
Me, what if they think they'll be happy in the future?
Ivo, then they are telling the laws of creation to delay their happiness. Many of you set out certain circumstances that are necessary for you to be happy. When I have $1 million, when I move into my house and land UFOs, when I lose 50 pounds. You can be happy now regardless of the condition of your physical lives. Do not practice conditional happiness. So when you complain, you are complaining because your present experience is falling short of your expectations. This tells you that some action must be taken in order to change your nows.
Me, like my neighbor cigarette smoke, which permeates my apartment because the windows are all shut now. Law of attraction, I got exactly the apartment I specified I wanted. The only thing I didn't specify was I wanted a healthy, non-toxic apartment, so there's mold in here and heavy secondhand smoke. I have air cleaners that are working overtime to clean it, and whenever possible I crack open the window to give the smell a place to go, but I end up breathing it in and coughing all the time.
Ivo, yes. So the string you left undealt with became your future lesson. You now desire your next place of abode to be non-toxic and healthy to breathe in. Because you lived this and decided you deserved a non-toxic place to live in.
Me, those are things I've always taken for granted though.
Ivo, on your earth? Wake up, my dear.
Me, yeah, that's true.
Ivo, you do what you can to deal with the toxicity and work to attract your next place to live that will not be toxic. In fact, you plan to grow many housey plants that will help to freshen the air. This could be done here as well, my love.
Me, true.
Ivo, so, today you woke up complaining because, yet again, you had nightmares. You understand that your bad mood is not directly related to anything in your physical, you are simply in a bad mood.
Me, yes. Although the cat did wake me up. But now I'm glad that he went outside in the sun and enjoyed himself, because I swear I can feel his boredom when he can't go out.
Ivo, yes, he is emotional as well. You pick up on his anxiety at not being able to patrol his territory because of the temperature.
Me, yes.
Ivo, but you understand you created your current circumstances. You see the law of attraction in action when you are in your apartment. You know you created this place. And it was the third apartment you looked at, so it did not take much to find it either. Law of action. You understand that your bad mood is simply a low vibrational state and you have not made it contingent on your current surroundings. When you accept your surroundings and that you created them, it gives you the power to understand that you can create new surroundings that are even more suitable to you. This is your lesson with this apartment, my love. It is a lesson that is showing you you are a creator being. You can create what you want to experience. You can also create what you do not want to experience by focusing on that as well, particularly by complaining of it, so do not complain about anything. It does no good for you except to attract and magnify that which you complain about you even more.
Me, that explains my life, Ivo.
Ivo, yes, you were a victim. You learned to complain because this was modeled to you by your mother, who was an expert complainer. Your mother expressed her dissatisfaction of her life with gusto.
Me, I felt sorry for her.
But yeah, she had a master's in complaining.
Ivo, yes. It was a pity, such potential that was denied in her. She was an intelligent woman. Had she attempted to be more positive, she might have found that things would have changed for her. Her vibration would have risen and her surroundings would have changed to reflect her higher frequency.
Me, yes.
But how do you become positive when your situation is bad?
Ivo, for one thing, removing yourself from it would help. What is more, imagining yourself in the now, in a better situation, one of your choosing. Use your imagination, and then take action when opportunities arise to create that reality. Do not imagine a future that is better, because then you are delaying your happiness. Imagine you are there now.
Me, yeah, but you're not.
Ivo, yes, but your imaginations are powerful tools of creation. They are there to assist you in creating a reality that is an expression of yourself. When you complain and do not accept your surroundings, you are expressing your powerlessness to change your life. You are abdicating your responsibility as a creator being. You are of the opinion that life happens to you. You are falling back into the role of the victim. In order to take your power back, there are things to be done. You heard your higher self the other day continually telling you to put the focus back on yourself. When you focus on what you feel is lacking in others, you are focusing on something you have no control over. It is the same as focusing on what you feel is lacking about yourself. But in this case, action can be taken to correct. You have power over yourself but none over others. You have also no right to interfere with their lives. Focusing on others' flaws gets you absolutely nowhere. Focusing on your own helps you to take action and to change your circumstances. Understanding that you can be happy regardless of your circumstances is a most powerful expression. Understanding that to be happy in all moments attracts more happiness is more powerful still. Complaining is an exercise in futility, an expression of powerlessness and an abdication of responsibility to self. You dealt with your complaining mood this morning by doing breathing exercises. You breathed energy into your chakras, going through each one and inhaling the prana, life force energy, in the air and applying it to the chakra. This lifted your mood. This will always change your perspective. You can be in the same apartment, sitting on the same couch, using the same computer, and at one moment all will look bleak and dark and the next wonderful and delightful. Why? Because your mood changed. You went from a lower vibrational state to a higher vibrational state by providing yourself with more energy. That is the only difference. You decided to feel and express a higher vibrational part of yourself, that is all. Anyone can make these changes in their nows. Anyone. It is very simple. Yes, this morning you were resistant. You did not think that you wanted to feel better. Of course, that is your choice. I do not see what would be enjoyable about being in a bad mood, but to each his own. Nonetheless, you picked yourself up and made a change, and that is commendable. You took responsibility for your mood and the consequent energies you are sending out to the universe. Life does not hand itself to you. It is the canvas. You are the artist. You can paint on your canvas whatever you wish. You can paint it black, or you can paint it in all the vibrant colors of light that you wish. You can paint dark figures or you can paint beautiful flowers. It is up to you. You have that much free will. Matrix influence accepted. Choose to create light, my love. Choose to create love. Love begets love, fear begets fear. Which do you choose to live in?
Me, Ivo. We've discussed complaining as being resistance to a better now. Can we discuss the roles of judgment and acceptance in this?
Ivo, of course. Judgment is also resistance to the now. Watch your reaction to any given situation, person, place or thing. Watch how you react. Your reaction tells you what it is that is either on point or that which needs changing. For example, you see a beautiful woman. Some will look at her and say, she is fat. And others will look and say, what a beautiful woman. Which experience do you want to have when you look at others? Both are judgments. The positive would be preferable to state, however, they are both judgments. It is better to describe than to judge. For example, there is a woman. Yes, your languages have adjectives and adverbs, and these are judgments. They are descriptions, and descriptions lead to judgments. I would at least recommend you stay away from the negative descriptions. Find the beauty in everything.
Me, what if it has no beauty?
Ivo, then that is on you. You are choosing not to see its beauty. That is resistance to love.
Me, what if it's a dark, ugly demonic? I've seen them. Where's the beauty in that?
Ivo, all life has beauty. If there is only one point to be made about it, find that point and ignore the 99% of other points that are negative. If the only point there is to be made that demon is alive, and life is love, then make that observation. Do not focus on the negative.
Me, what if I'm here to fight the negative?
Ivo, there is still acceptance of the negative, the dark, as being forms of life. And life is an expression of love. In these cases, a minimal expression, but an expression nonetheless.
Me, okay.
Ivo, your resistance comes from the fact that there are conditioned ways to view these things. There are what you would call typical reactions. A typical reaction to a car accident would be to say, that is awful.
Me, so where do you find the positive in a car accident, Ivo? Especially if you're the one in it?
Ivo, perhaps not focus on the negative, but to say, I was in a car accident.
Me, and then brace for the barrage of sympathy you'd be getting from people who tell you that that was a negative experience for you and we are so sorry it happened to you, bearing in mind you actually created it for yourself,
yeah.
Which is kind of them, of course.
Ivo, then that may be the positive that there is to be found in a car accident, that so many are showing their care and concern for you. That may be the only positive. The outpouring of love. Or that you even recognizes that on a higher level this accident was created by you for you to learn from. That is another positive. It does not always feel good for you, however, that is the way you label it. Your people label pain as bad.
Me, it hurts to be in pain.
Ivo, then think how much better it will be when the pain goes away.
Me, what about people with chronic pain?
Ivo, yes. Your people do not understand that pain, be it emotional or physical, is created by blockages, resistance to the life force in oneself. The chi. When the chi flows, then life is less painful. Your world will change much in the world of medicine and healing in the next 50 years, and part of this will be the understanding of basic body care. And why pain occurs within the body. Yes, there are books already written by those with this understanding. You Can Heal Your Life, by Louise Hay, being one of them. Now as many go through ascension, painful symptoms are occurring, and this is because old pain blocks are being removed from lower and heart chakras and you are re-feeling the pain stored in the past when you repressed it. Undealt with emotional pain creates blockages in the chakras, which then create physical symptoms of pain in the body. In summary, work towards that acceptance of all and loving of all. Do not resist what is put before you. At least view it with neutrality.
Me, thank you, Ivo.
Ivo, my love, you are most welcome. I await you.